strength of my heart and my portion forever. To be absent from the body, to be present with the Lord, he's getting that. He's getting that. What Paul said about 800 years later, he's getting it right here. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. My heart, my flesh may fail. It's frustrating. Frustrating when your flesh fails. But God is our portion, and he's the strength of our heart. For behold, those who are far from him shall perish. You put an end to everyone who is unfaithful to you. But for me, it's good to be near God. I've made the Lord my refuge, that I may tell of all your works. Look, God is not, salvation is not a fire insurance policy. It's not an insurance policy at all.
What kind of insurance would that be? That guy's stupid.
Salvation calls you. And salvation changes you. There are a lot of things that I would change in my life. If I could go back and change things, there are things that I would change. I wouldn't change the day that I came to Jesus. I wouldn't change seeking to follow him the best I can. I regret that. My regrets come when I try to do what Asaph said he almost did. My regrets come from living that way. And look, I have. One of the great things about God's word is that it gives us promises that we can hold on to, even in our regrets. And you know, I've caused pain in my life. I've caused people pain. I've hurt people. I've done some stupid things in my life. But God will wipe away all these tears. So I think when I'm called into account for everything that I've done, I'm going to give account, so are you. I think that's going to be heartbreaking. I think that's going to be a heartbreaking moment. And that's why God will wipe away all tears. And they'll never be remembered again in eternity. Why do the wicked prosper? They don't. Oh, they may, according to the standard of this world, but they don't. They don't. You hear me say it all the time, live with the end in mind. Don't live for today. Don't live for tomorrow. It's so hard to live for the end in mind when you're a teenager. But live with the end in mind. You got to think about now how you're going to finish. You can't win a race
without losing.
You can't win a race just as a race starts. But you can sure lose. So you run with the end in mind. And you deny yourself some things that seem to be better. But they're not. They're not better. They just seem to be better. For the glory of God. Psalm 70, 2, 3. 3. It's a good word. Now, I hesitate to ask this. Does anyone have any questions? Different mailboxes? Yeah. Y'all know each other at all? Okay. All right. Let me pray.
Father, I thank you for your word. God, I pray. Lord, I pray we'll be faithful. Father, I pray we seek you. God, I know there's a lot of folks that seem like they've got it made. There's a lot of stuff that seems so good. But those things lead to death. And those things lead to regret and heartache and pain. God, I pray we would live with the end in mind. We would run the race with patience. I pray you'd be honored and glorified in our lives. I pray for these students as they prepare to begin a new year. God, I pray they'd just passionately seek you. And as they do, they would share the good news with others as they have opportunity. I pray that be true in my life as well. I pray for Brother Dustin and Angela and the girls on their way. May you just give them a great time together. Thank you for salvation that comes through Jesus. I pray in his name. Amen. Thank you all.
Have a nice day.
It's just like a commercial.
Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
I just hope everybody has a good day.
You know the one thing I don't get about nowadays, people when you're so depressed it makes you unbearable because I've been seeing that lately with my other chaplains on the media. A lot of people are trying to do some really stupid depressing stuff. Don't turn on the lights yet.
Why not? You know what that means when they turn the lights on?
Elvis has left the building.
That means it's time to go.
Elvis has left the building.
I gotta get my stuff.
Get your stuff.